One of the allegations against Shaka Armer was that he travelled to Afghanistan in 2001 using a false passport.
Did you ever travel on a false passport?
Yes, I did.
When?
When I left this country.
Why did you travel on a false passport?
Because I tried to go back to Saudi Arabia and they actually confiscated my passport. And I have no other way to go out of this country but with a false passport. And I admitted that. Because I don't believe anybody should be grounded and should be locked up from going and living in where he wants to live. Why? Because I don't have a piece of paper. It says me so and so.
But it's illegal to travel on a false passport.
It is illegal, but what can I do if they refuse to give me a travel document?
He says one of the reasons he travelled to Afghanistan in the first place was due to the abuse his wife was suffering in the UK.
Why would you go to Afghanistan and take your wife and children to a place that was run by the Taliban?
My wife, out of his own will, she wore a full niqab. She covered herself completely. Unfortunately, a lot of people, they don't understand that's her choice. And a lot of the time, she will be called names because of the way she is. And truly, when I went there, you know, we are just like everybody else.
It would be extraordinary to most people to hear that you wanted to live somewhere that you felt comfortable.
Yes.
That it wasn't Britain, but that it was under the Taliban in Kabul.
Yes. It was comfortable there.
An Islamic fundamentalist regime that slaughtered civilians and wouldn't educate many women.
That's all something is being told about them.
Shaka Armer also admits to knowing one controversial figure in particular, Abu Qatada, the radical cleric extradited to Jordan from Britain.
What about Abu Qatada?
Abu Qatada, yes, I know him.
You know him?
Yes.
What do you think of him?
I think he have nothing to do with anything to do with bin Laden at all. All what he was doing is breaching the people to wake up the people about the Middle East and what's going on in the Middle East.
Well, some people say it was out and out radicalization. We know what the charges are that are against Abu Qatada.
Julie, I know this guy from Friday prayers. We used to sit, you know, talk and all that. And I don't believe not a second that man is radicalizing anybody or he is a terrorist or we believe in terrorism.